Oh, yeah. I've got a feeling everything is gonna be all right.
I've got a feeling everything is gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything is gonna be all right. Be all right.
Be all right.
Be all right.
Oh, somebody told me everything is gonna be all right.
Everything is gonna be all right.
The Holy Ghost already told me
everything's gonna be all right.
Yeah,
it's gonna be
all right.
Be all right.
Be all right.
Be all right.
Be all right.
I'm here to tell you everything is gonna be all right. Listen to me.
I'm here to tell you everything's gonna be all right.
Today we celebrate the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
And let us put ourselves before God's mercy and compassion. Lord Jesus, you come to forgive our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to heal our broken hearts. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to guide us by your Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Alone.
Let us bow our heads and pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon the love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your command to love, we may be signs of your love to many. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The godless say, "Let us lie in wait for the righteous one, who makes life inconvenient to us and opposes our actions, who reproaches us for sins against the law and accuses us of sins against our training. Let us see if his words are true, and let us test what will happen at the end of his life. For if the righteous one is God's son, God will help him and will deliver him from the hand of his adversaries. Let us test him with insult and torture, so that we may find how gentle he is and make trial of his forbearance. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to what he says, he will be protected." My brothers and sisters, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall always be on my lips. My soul shall glory in the Lord, for he has been so good to me. Oh, taste and see. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see. Taste and see the goodness of the Worship the Lord, all you people. You'll want for nothing if you ask. Taste and see that God is good. In Him
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where there is envy and selfish ambition, there will also be disorder and wickedness of every kind. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make peace. Those conflicts and disputes among you, where do they come from? Do they not come from your cravings that are at war within you? You want something and you do not have it, so you commit murder. And you covet something and cannot obtain it, so you engage in disputes and conflict. You do not have because you do not ask. You ask and you do not receive because you ask wrongly, in order to spend what you get on your pleasures. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia,
according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After leaving the mountain, Jesus and his disciples went from there and passed through Galilee. He did not want anyone to know it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man is to be betrayed into the hands of men, and they will kill him. And then 3 days after being killed, he will rise again." But they did not understand what he was saying and were afraid to ask him. Then they came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, Jesus asked them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they were silent, for they had been arguing with one another who was the greatest. Jesus sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "Whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all." Then he took a little child, put it among them, and taking him in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes such a child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me." My brothers and sisters, our salvation, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You can always imagine the scene painted in today's gospel. Here are the disciples walking along and arguing over who's the greatest. You can hear the conversation. Peter says, They called me the rock, so I must be the most important. One of the other guys says, I take care of the money, so I'm the most important. Another one says, but I help to do some of the healings, and so I must be the most important. Finally, Jesus says, hey guys, what are you talking about? They all got silent because I knew they were asking each other like some stupid questions. And Jesus says, you guys don't get it. See, the background is, at this point in the story, the apostles really think that Jesus is going to bring in his own earthly kingdom. And they think of a kingdom like, you know, with a king and secondary people and other people in charge, and they're trying to get a good position. And Jesus says, no, no. I'm building a kingdom of God's justice and mercy here. And of course, this flies over the guys. It's like talking to a brick wall. And then Jesus says, in our kingdom, it's not about status, it's about service. And then there's an illustration. He takes a little child and puts a child in front of him and says, whoever welcomes this child welcomes me. But the background is, at that point, children were not valued at all. They were seen as sort of helpless. They needed, you know, family to take care of them. And they were basically almost expendable. And so Jesus is saying, if you help someone who is of this little import, if you help someone who's this powerless, basically, then you're welcoming me. And so he says, you know, it's all about service. It's not about trying to look good. It's about doing good. It's the same thing we hear at the end of Matthew's gospel, Matthew chapter 25. It says, whatever we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we do for Jesus. And it seems to go against the sense many people have that, you know, we're all trying to figure out how we can improve our status and, you know, do better and get a better car and a better house and a better job and fill in the blank. It's similar for, as a priest, you know, that over the years I've had many people say, well, you know, Mike, couldn't you ever do better than just hanging out like at St. Martin's? I said, I got the best job going. I love what I do. I know I make a difference every day. I serve lots of people of all kind of backgrounds. But over the years, just to know, in the kind of the priestly culture, if I was trying to get ahead, I would have said yes to many opportunities to work in the headquarters, the pastoral center. I would have taken many other options to get a bigger parish, which was offered a couple times. And I kept saying no. And they wouldn't understand, but what I wanted to say to them is, my whole goal is to be a simple parish priest. Of course, some parishioners tell me about as simple as you get. But the point is that, you know, I really tried early on in my life to do what the scripture says, to serve the least, the lonely, the lost, to take care of the little people, like the little children, and people who often don't have other resources, connect people who have the resources with folks who need the resources. You know, we each have many opportunities, probably every day, but definitely every week, to often help those who are the least, the lonely, the lost. Those people who are really struggling, and often our little bit of kindness can really be a blessing to them. And in doing so, try not to see them as a burden, but try to see what the scriptures say, that that is Jesus in our midst. Whenever we welcome one of the least, we welcome Jesus. To me, that's really good news. Amen. I invite you to pray with me our belief in the creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. Let us lift up to the Lord our needs and the needs of our church. For all those who are struggling to get vaccinated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the Afghan refugees, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For racial justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those returning to school, they may do so safely, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I invite you to lift up your own needs and concerns. Lord God, we present to you these and all those needs that burden our hearts. We make them known through your Son, Jesus, who lives with and through us now and forever.
Amen.
As we prepare our altar, the good news is this week, I've gotten mail 5 out of 6 days. That's like a Class A miracle around here. So I just want to update you for those who are keeping track of how our mail service is going. Maybe it will continue to go well. That way, when you send in your donations and checks, we'll actually get them within a week or two. Lord God, we ask that you bless this bread and this wine, fruit of the field and fruit of the vines that soon becomes the very body and blood of Jesus. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours become acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. For our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what we profess with faith may strengthen us for the journey through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all that you've made and forever praise you in your mighty works through your Son, Jesus. We join all the angels as we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilton, our bishop, and all of the women and men who lead and guide the church. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. We pray especially for all those who've died from COVID-19. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray for the fullness of God's kingdom as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
And those who are blessed to have others around you, I invite you now to share a sign of the Lord's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite those who cannot be with us in person to spiritually ask the risen Lord to come into your hearts, to help you not get stuck building your personal kingdom, but to be strengthened to build God's kingdom of mercy and justice. This is the body of Christ.
Just wanna praise you forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory and honor.
Let us bow our heads and pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may possess your eternal redemption, both in mystery and in the way of our daily life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to pray with us our prayer for justice and human dignity crafted by Cardinal Gregory and the bishops of our diocese. Loving and faithful God, we come to you, Father, to ask through your Son, Jesus, in a communion with the Holy Spirit, you help us in the battle against America's original sin of racism that divides us from being the body of Christ that we are called to be as your children. We implore you to give us your wisdom so that we may build a community founded on the gospel message of the life and dignity of all people from the womb to the tomb, and to live in communion like the divine communion of the Holy Trinity. Bless parents that they may form their children in faith to love one another regardless of skin color, ethnicity, and national origin, just as Jesus loves us. Bless and protect all of us as we live out our faith and being instruments of your peace, as St. Francis said. Fill us with a thirst for justice and righteousness. Hear our prayer and give us the courage, compassion, and perseverance to root out any form of injustice within our communities and bring the healing love of Christ to all in need. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Church, hasten to help us and intercede on our behalf so that our archdiocese can continue to witness the gospel message of the life and dignity of all people. Amen. Our announcements. Sunday school begins this weekend, so on September the 19th is the first Sunday school experience. It's online, so hopefully you have registered. If not, if you can't figure out how to do it, send me an email and I'll send it off to June and she'll get you all taken care of. So just it'd be good to get everybody at one time. We'll also be getting our process for those who want to become fully Catholic. Either you never got baptized or you need to be confirmed or you've been coming to church as a pretend Catholic for years. We're now beginning to do that. We'll begin that process, the rite of Christian initiation for adults, virtually, and then maybe later on in person. So we have a few people already in the group, So if you're interested, let me know and I'll again connect you with the right people, the team. We're still collecting money for the Afghan women's personal care kits. They're $10 each. St. Martin's has already donated $1,000 toward this. If you donate, that money goes back to reimburse us so we can help other people with outreach. Let's see, birthdays I know about. June's birthday was September the 12th. And Kim Taylor's is September the 10th. And this coming September the 20th is, September 20th is Deacon Bobby's 24th ordination as a deacon. So special occasions, 24 years. And just think of the 24 years Deacon Bobby's been an ordained deacon, he spent the most of the time with us at St. Martin's. Thank you, Jesus. It's a blessing in many, many ways. That's all I have for my announcements. I think that's all I need to tell you this time. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord continue to strengthen us that we can build God's kingdom of justice, mercy, and peace around us. Let the church say,
amen.
May the Lord give blessing in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As you go, tell the world. As you go, tell the world. Tell the world about Jesus. Tell them about his love. Tell the world about Jesus. Tell them about his love. As you go, tell the world. As you go, tell the world. Tell the world about Jesus. Tell them about his love. Tell the world about Jesus. Tell them about his love. As you go, tell the world. As you go, tell the world. Tell the world about Jesus. Tell them about his love. Tell the world about Jesus. Tell them about his love. As you go, tell the world. As you go, tell the world.